The use cases pertain to Atlas Auto Parts, an online retailer, which sells a variety of goods ranging from auto parts to fuzzy dice. The demo is showcased in three parts. The first part showcases how an API administrator interacts with IICS's API manager. John, an Atlas customer, signs into their website and starts searching for a part, a fuzzy dice for his 1972 Vega. He finds the part. The SKU is INT1782. It's $12. He adds this to his cart. Now, the website initiates an API call to the APIs that Atlas has created on IICS. The API call goes through the API gateway, which monitors and secures access to the APIs and the data that Atlas is exposing to its partners. Atlas's API administrator, Roger, can use the IICS API manager to track access to Atlas's website and look at the list of managed APIs that are exposed. He reviews the expedited purchase API, which is the business process that gets triggered with the API call from the website, and verifies that the API policy has been set at 5 requests per 30 seconds. This is to ensure that the website is not overwhelmed by requests. The analytics dashboard gives visibility into all activities that have occurred between the website and retail partners over a period of time. Roger looks at activities over the last 30 days. You see that it's easy to identify trends, like the fact that Atlas gets a lot more traffic over the weekends. You can also see that the top APIs are Get Parts, Look Up Invoice and Customer Details, Order Processor, and Expedited Purchase, which is the API that Roger is looking at. Roger can also drill down to view the APIs by number of occurrences and to see the set of activities that have happened for each of these APIs. The Security tab details API calls that exceed policies. For example, here, where we see too many requests. When Roger views historical logs, he can see that there are numerous too many requests responses and that there's even one here which is unauthorized. So, Roger uses API Manager to track access and implement a set of services that manage organizational policies, such as the default rate limit policy or IP filtering policies to control which sites are allowed or denied. Now, let's say Roger wants to implement a new service in order to update, track, cancel, and set orders. And he wants this new service to be available to Atlas's partners, the retailers that are placing orders through this website. Not a problem. He can place this new service under management using the API Manager. In the list of all services, he searches for the order processor and creates a managed API. Then, we can see in the list of managed APIs the newly created order processor. Roger can then configure the API details, set the rate limit, in this case 2 per 30 seconds, click update, and close. And the administrator has a new service under management that has monitored rate limits. To test this service, Roger can copy the managed URL and invoke it. The item name and count is entered, and the order is received. The activity log now shows the details of this new API call. We can see that it ran in 11 milliseconds. The second part of the three-part demo pertains to Atlas, an online auto parts retailer, and showcases how IT operations can monitor services and APIs, ensure the business process moves forward, and provide support in case of exceptions. Amit, an IT operations engineer, uses the application integration console to monitor activities and security information for the APIs that are being invoked. He sees an expedited purchase from an Atlas website customer. Looking further, he understands that in this case, the implementation of the API is an orchestration that accepts orders for a product SKU of INT1782. Amit sees that when the order was placed, a 10% discount was offered to John, a repeat customer who has provided his telephone number. Additionally, Amit can use the console to determine how much time is spent on every step of the order fulfillment process. This is useful to be able to determine if and when services are running slowly. Every time someone visits the Atlas website, it records an opportunity within Salesforce. And Amit can see here that a specific opportunity call to Salesforce has been placed. Now, the heavy lifting of the fulfillment process starts. Through the console, Amit drills into the fulfillment process and sees the implementation of that service. Before we drill into the details, let's go back to the starting process list to see what really happened. The expedited purchase process made a call to the fulfillment process, which initiated the fulfillment. Now let's go back to looking at the process in more detail. The first step is to determine whether the 10% discount offered by the website is appropriate. To do this, the fulfillment process makes a call to the verified discount business rule service, which makes the determination that the discount is approved. As it's been auto-approved, the process follows the top branch. If it isn't approved, an email rejection is sent to the manager, and John can be informed that there's a problem with the order he's just placed. For most of the auto parts inventory, the price and availability don't change much, so it's appropriate to store this information in your CRM, Salesforce in this particular case, and use data integration to keep the inventory and pricing information up to date in Salesforce on an hourly or daily basis. Certain parts just fly off the shelf, like fuzzy dice for a 1972 Vega. Information for these parts is stored in an inventory database, and Amit can initiate a dynamic lookup in the inventory database to determine the current price and availability of fuzzy dice. The next step is preparing the shipping details. To do so, Salesforce is accessed to collect the address and parts information that John provided. And then the Salesforce record is updated with the tracking ID number as the order is about to be placed. Then, using multi-channel fulfillment, three things happen in parallel. First, a notification is sent that parts are going to be shipped to the address obtained from Salesforce. Second, the order information is published to IICS's Cloud Integration Hub via an API. The subscribers for the Cloud Integration Hub, such as NetSuite, receive the order information every hour to do actual fulfillment. The second subscriber to Cloud Integration Hub is a Redshift cloud database that drives a Tableau dashboard to look at orders for any given time frame. And finally, evidence of the order is placed into a backend system, in this case, an AMQP messaging topic, to initiate the delivery process. This process flow provides Atlas a seamless execution from order fulfillment to delivery. This third part of the three-part demo showcases how a developer at Atlas Auto Parts, an online retailer, can use application integration to build the processes that become APIs. Our developer, Ravi, uses cloud application integration to build various business processes which are ultimately exposed as APIs. He's created a project called Expedited Purchasing. He's also created some connections and mappings, and has service connectors that provide the ability to integrate any SOAP service or REST service that exists, in addition to the connectors that Informatica provides. Let's look at the fulfillment process. Ravi would like to upgrade the order processes so the business is able to not only initiate the order, but also track, cancel, and update the order. He uses cloud application integration to create a new order service, the order processor service, that's going to be called by the fulfillment process to support the ability to initiate the order, update the order, check status of the order, or cancel the order. This is a capability that's unique to Informatica because it allows Ravi to post a long-running process, like this order process which could be running for days, and interact with it by sending it messages, such as to check the status. Now Ravi will add this order processing service to the existing fulfillment process. Doing so is as simple as dropping in a sub-process, where he then embeds the code. He's going to make a call to this service, and then he'll invoke the order processing service, which is stored in processes like this. Next, he's going to call a start action. There are other actions as well, such as cancel order, check status, and update order. But first, he's going to start it. Ravi already knows that item name and item count are required fields, so he maps them and sets both fields. When the Atlas customer, John, places a website order, the product name comes in as a product SKU. He maps that to item name, and the number of each item ordered comes in as unit count, which he maps to item count. That's all the information required to map from prior steps and place this order. Ravi saves it successfully and publishes it to deploy the service. Now the service has been updated. So the next time the fulfillment process is called, it will act with this new definition. Thanks to the new process flow, Ravi was able to effortlessly provide more flexibility to Atlas Auto Parts. This demonstrates the capabilities of IICS, which includes API and application integration, data integration, and cloud integration hub. We have created new sets of capabilities that provide customers with the ability to integrate data between various systems, automate processes, expose these processes and integrations as APIs, place them under management, and track the execution of these APIs. And all of this helps deliver significant new value to Atlas Auto Parts.